Hi students, good morning and welcome to the new episode of our English class. In the previous class we completed our fourth lesson and today we are moving on to the fifth lesson. Our fifth lesson is a change of heart. Our fifth lesson, what is the title of the fifth lesson? A change of heart. A change of heart. A change, see, a change, change of heart. H-E-A-R-T, heart. A change of heart. Okay, take page number 43. All of you take page number 43, this one. And this is the order one section. Here is an instruction. Unscramble the words, then match each word with the correct picture. Some words are given here and some pictures are also given in the other side. The pictures and words are not in correct order. The words are in general order. Then first of all, we have to unscramble the words and make meaningful words and then match the word with the correct animal. Okay, is it clear? First one is B-A-B-I-R-T. Which is the word? R-A-B-B-I-T. Rabbit. The first word. Which is the first word? R-A-B-B-I-T. Rabbit. R-A-B-B-I-T. You write the capital letters. R-A-B-B-I-T. Using your pencil, you write the text. R-A-B-B-I-T. Rabbit. Next one. Parrot. P-A-R-O-T. Parrot. Which is the next word? Second word? P-A-R-O-T. Parrot. P-A-R-O-T. Parrot. Next one. Skewer. Yes. Q-U-I-R-E-R. Skewer. Yes. Q-U-I-R-E-R. Skewer. Spelling is plural. Yes. Q-U-I-R-E-R. Skewer. Next one. Monkey. M-O-N-K-E-Y. Monkey. M-O-N-K-E-Y. Monkey. M-O-N-K-E-Y. Monkey. Which is the first word? You say the spelling and write, then there won't be any mistake. R-A-B-B-I-T. Rabbit. R-A-B-B-I-T. Rabbit. Then parrot. P-A-R-R-O-T. Parrot. Next word. Skewer. S-Q-U-I-R-R-E-R. Skewer. Monkey. M-O-N-K-E-Y. Monkey. M-O-N-K-E-Y. Monkey. Okay. Do you finish writing? Then you have to match the word with the correct animal. Picture. Word of the picture. First one, rabbit. The word is the first one and the picture is the last one. You draw a line to match the word with the animal. Rabbit. You match like this. First word and the last picture. Okay. Then next one. Parrot. Second word and the second last picture. Second word and the second last picture. Rabbit. Then third word and the second picture. Squirrel. Third word and the second picture. Squirrel. Then last word and the first picture. Monkey. Last word and the first picture. Which is the first picture? Monkey. First one. I am writing just for your knowledge. You don't write the numbers. One. Then rabbit. Fourth one. Four. Parrot. Third one. Then squirrel. Second picture. This is the order. Rabbit. Fourth one. Parrot. Third one. Squirrel. Second one. Monkey, first one. Okay, is it clear? Now let us move on to the lesson. English. Inki the monkey. Who is Inki? Monkey. I-N-K-Y. Inki. Inki is the monkey. M-O-N-K-Y. M-O-N-K-E-Y. Monkey. Inki is the monkey. The name of the monkey? Inki. Then next one, Chinu the rabbit. Who is the rabbit? Chinu. Chinu is the rabbit. R-A-B-B-I-T. Spelling of rabbit? R-A-B-B-I-T. Rabbit. Then who is this? What is the name of the squirrel? S-Q-U-I-R-R-E-L. Squirrel. Squeaky. Yes. Q-U-E-A-K-Y. Squeaky. Squeaky is the name of the squirrel. Squeaky. S-Q-U-E-A-K-Y. Squeaky is the squirrel. S-Q-U-I-R-R-E-L. Squeaky is the squirrel. Squeaky is the squirrel. And then who is the parrot? Pecky is the parrot. P-E-C-K-Y. Pecky is the parrot. P-A-R-R-O-T. Pecky is the parrot. Okay, listen. If you study all these four animals and their four animals and their names, it is very easy to understand the lesson. Okay, who is the monkey? Inki. What is the name of the monkey? Inki. Then what is the name of the rabbit? Chinu. What is the name of the rabbit? Chinu. The name of the squirrel? Squeaky. Who is Squeaky? The squirrel. Who is Squeaky? The squirrel. Then who is Pecky? The parrot. Say the name of the parrot? Pecky. Name of the squirrel? Squeaky. Name of the monkey? Inki. Name of the rabbit? Rabbit? Chinu. Chinu is the rabbit. Okay, is it clear? Can you study the four names? Yes. Inki the monkey, Chinu the rabbit, Squeaky the squirrel, and Pecky the parrot were friends. They were friends. They were friends and they are living in the same forest. They are living in the same forest. They were friends. They lived in a mango orchard. Where do these animals live? Where do these birds and animals live? They lived in a mango orchard. The name of the orchard. Orchard means garden. O-R-C-H-A-R-D. Orchard. O-R-C-H-A-R-D. What is the meaning of orchard? Garden. Orchard means garden. G-A-R-D-E-N. Garden. What is the meaning of orchard? Garden. Who is living in the mango orchard? The animals and the birds were living in the mango orchard. Who were living in the mango orchard? A monkey, a parrot, a squirrel, and a rabbit. A rabbit, a monkey, a squirrel, and a parrot. Who is the monkey? Inki. Who is the parrot? Pecky. Who is the squirrel? Squeaky. Who is the rabbit? Chinu. Okay, is it clear now? The names of the four animals are given here and they were living in a mango orchard. Orchard means garden. Where do these animals live? These animals were living in a mango orchard and they were very good friends. They were very good friends. This is the first paragraph. I will read it once more. Inki the monkey. You please listen carefully to the text. Inki the monkey. Chinu the rabbit. Squeaky the squirrel. And Pecky the parrot were friends. They lived in a mango orchard. They lived in a mango orchard. Inki the monkey. Chinu the rabbit, Squeaky the squirrel, and Pecky the parrot were friends. They lived in a mango orchard. Pecky would taste a mango, and if it was sweet, Inki would prick it, and then all the four would share the food. What was their daily habit? Pecky would taste a mango. Who is Pecky? The parrot will taste a mango to check whether it is ripe or not. He will check. Who is the first one to taste the mango? Pecky. The parrot will peck at the fruit and check whether it is ripe or not. Pecky would taste a mango. The spelling of taste, T-A-S-T-E. Becky would taste the mango, taste the fruit to check whether it is ripe or not. If it is the ripe one, yes, Becky one, who will pluck the fruit? Ingi will pluck the fruit. Ingi will pluck it, and then all the four would share the fruit. Then what is their habit? All the four, these four animals will share the sweet fruit. Share. Such a ani, share. Divide into four. Share. Means they divide for themselves. They share the fruit. They eat it by sharing. They are sharing the fruit. I read that paragraph also. Ingi the monkey, Chinnu the rabbit, Squeaky the squirrel, and Pecky the parrot were friends. They lived in a mango orchard. Where do they live? They lived in a mango orchard. Pecky would taste a mango, and if it is sweet, Ingi would pluck it. Pecky would taste the mango. Who is tasting the mango? Pecky the parrot. Then who is plucking the mango? Ingi the monkey will pluck it. And then all the four would share the food. And then all four of them were sharing the food, and they are having it shared. Okay. Then one day, Ingi's cousin Cheeky came to spend his holidays. Who came with their four friends? Who came there in the midst of these four friends? Cheeky. 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 Who is Cheeky? The cousin of Ingi. Cheeky, the cousin of Ingi. Cousin of Ingi means the cousin of this monkey. Cheeky came there. They were living very harmoniously. That means they were living in harmony, in complete happiness, because there is nothing partiality. There is no partiality in between them. There is no clash in between them. There is no opposition of ideas in between them. They are very harmony. They are living in extreme harmony, extreme happiness. And the parrot is tasting the fruit to check whether it is sweet. If it is sweet, the monkey will pluck the fruit, and they will share the fruit by themselves. Okay, they were living happily, and at that time, one animal came there. One more animal came there. Who is the guest? Cheeky. Who is Cheeky? The cousin of Ingi, the monkey. Who is Cheeky? The cousin of Ingi came there to spend his holidays. There is a new word, spend, S-P-E-N-D. S-P-E-N-D, spend the holidays, H-O-L-I-D-A-Y-S. What is the meaning of holidays? In our school, we have one of holidays, Christmas holidays, and then summer holidays. Where do you go to spend your holidays? You were going to your grandmother's house, or uncle's house, or your relative's house. You are going to your relative's house for spending holidays. Nowadays, you are having holidays on every day because of the COVID-19 virus. Okay. At that time, they were living in a forest or in a mango orchard, and the four friends were living very happily, and they were sharing the things they get. Okay. At that time, there came the cousin of Ingi. What is the name of Ingi's cousin? Cheeky. Why did he came there? He came there. Why did he come there? He came there to spend the holidays. Cheeky came there to spend the holiday with his cousin and the friends. Cheeky came there to spend the holidays with his cousin and the friends. One day, Ingi's cousin, the spelling of cousin is C-O-U-S-I-N, C-O-U-S-I-N, cousin, C-O-U-S-I-N, cousin. Who is the cousin of Ingi? The cousin of Ingi is Cheeky. He came there to spend his holidays. He was very naughty and selfish. But all the other four animals were naughty, were not naughty, and they were not selfish. They were sharing things without any partiality. But here, Cheeky is very naughty. Naughty means mischievous. Naughty, N-A-U-G-H-T-Y, naughty. Cheeky is very naughty and selfish. The bitter quality of a person, selfish. He always wanted to eat the sweetest food. He did not want to share the sweet fruit or sweetest food with anybody. He did not want to share the sweetest food with anybody. He always wanted to have it by himself. He always wanted. Always means like always. Always. He always wanted to. Wanted to eat the sweetest food. Wanted. 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 He always wanted to eat the sweetest food. Sweetest. Yes. Yes. It is a superlative. We have sweet. Sweet means madhuram. More sweet and most sweet. Sweeter. Sweeter than the other one. It is super comparative degree. Then sweetest is the superlative degree that you will study in your higher classes. It is sweetest, that means the most sweet one. The most sweet one. The most sweet one is called the sweetest. Okay. Then we will look into the paragraph once more. One day, Inge's cousin G.K. came to spend his holidays. He was very naughty and selfish. He always wanted to eat the sweetest food. He always wanted to eat the sweetest food. Look in the new words. Orcha. Say the new words. Say the spelling and the meaning. So say the spelling and the word. Okay. Orcha. O-R-C-H-A-R-D. Orcha. Orcha means garden. G-A-R-D-E-N. Orcha means garden. Then taste. T-A-S-T-E. Taste. T-A-S-T-E. Taste. Then next word, pluck. P-L-U-C-K. Pluck. P-L-U-C-K. Pluck. Then next word, share. S-H-A-R-E. Share. S-H-A-R-E. Share. Next word, spend. S-P-E-N-D. Spend. S-P-E-N-D. Spend. Next word, holidays. H-O-L-I-D-A-Y-S. Say the spelling and word. H-O-L-I-D-A-Y-S. Holidays. Next word, cousin. C-O-U-S-I-N. Cousin means our cousin sister and cousin brothers. Cousin. Next word, naughty. N-A-U-G-S-T-Y. Naughty means mischievous. Mischievous. N-A-U-G-H-T-Y. Next word, selfish. S-E-L-F-I-S. Selfish. Next word, always. A-L-W-A-Y-S. Always. A-L-W-A-Y-S. Always. Next word, wanted. W-A-N-T-E-D. Wanted. W-A-N-T-E-D. Wanted. Next word, sweetest. S-W-E-E-T-E-S-T. I will read this once more. You please listen. Orcha. Taste. Pluck. Share. Spend. Holidays. Garden. Cousin. Naughty. Selfish. Always. Wanted. Sweetest. Okay, who are the characters in this story? Ingi, the monkey. Then Jiki, the cousin of Ingi. Then Chinnu, the rabbit. Sneaky, the squirrel. Then Pecky, the parrot. They are the characters in this story. And read from the very beginning. You please listen. Ingi the monkey, Chinnu the rabbit, Squeaky the squirrel, and Pecky the parrot were friends. They lived in a mango orchard. Pecky would taste a mango if it was sweet, Ingi would pluck it, and then all the four would share the fruit. Okay, one day, Ingi's cousin Jiki came to spend some of his holidays. He was very naughty and selfish. Who is naughty and selfish? Jiki, the cousin of Ingi, was selfish and naughty. And he always wanted to eat the sweetest fruit. Jiki always wanted to eat the sweetest fruit. Okay. Then, Pecky the parrot and Squeaky the squirrel thought of an idea. There was no selfishness between the four before Jiki arrived there. So, Squeaky the squirrel and Pecky the parrot thought of an idea. Who were planning for an idea? Squeaky and Pecky were planning for an idea. They have an idea about the selfishness of Jiki. They have Pecky the parrot and Squeaky the squirrel thought of an idea. They think of an idea to change the one newcomer Cheeky. Thought. T-H-O-U-G-H-T. Thought. T-H-O-U-G-H-T. Thought. They thought of an idea. And Pecky tasted the sweetest food, but Ingy the monkey did not like them. As always, Pecky tasted the sweetest food. It was the sweetest one. Pecky tasted the sweetest food, but Ingy the monkey did not pluck them for them. One day, Ingy's cousin Cheeky came to spend his holidays. He was very naughty and selfish. He always wanted to eat the sweetest fruit. Pecky the parrot and Squeaky the squirrel thought of an idea. Pecky tasted the sweetest fruit, but Ingy the monkey did not pluck them as he wanted them for his cousin. Okay, let us stop here today and let us look at some small questions and answers from this from today's topic. First question. You need not write this in your notebook. I am just writing it for your knowledge. Okay, for making you thorough about the lesson. Who were the four friends?
Mango orchard.
The friends live in a Fourth one. Who played the flute? Who played the flute? Ingi the monkey played the flute. Ingi the monkey played the flute. Who came there to spend the holidays? Fifth question. Who came there to spend the holidays? Who came there? Katie are there to spend holidays. Who came there to spend the holidays? Cheeky, the cousin of Ingi. Who came there to spend the holidays? Cheeky, the cousin of Ingi. What was his nature? What was the nature of Cheeky? Sixth one. What was the nature of Cheeky? What was his nature? What was his nature? He was selfish and naughty. He was naughty and selfish. He was naughty and selfish. Then which are the other questions we can name? Who thought of an idea? Pecky and Squeaky thought of an idea. Okay, it is the first part of this lesson, and today let us stop here. You read, you study the questions, not write in your notebook. I will give you the notes. Then you try to find out this kind of questions from the topic, that day's topic. Whenever the class comes to you, you try to find out while reading the test. You try to find out the simple questions and find out the answers of that questions. Then it is very easy for you to study. Okay. Who are the animals? I am going to say once more. Who were the four friends? The parrot, the squirrel, the rabbit, and the monkey were the four friends. What were their names? Ingi the monkey, Pecky the parrot, Squeaky the squirrel, and Chinu the rabbit. Then, where do the friends live? Where do these four friends live? These four friends live in a mango orchard. Who takes the fruit? The parrot will taste the fruit. Then, who plucked the fruit? The monkey will pluck the fruit. Then who came there to spend the holidays? Cheeky, the cousin of Ingi, came there to spend the holidays. Then what was his nature? He was selfish and naughty. He was very selfish and naughty. Okay, is it clear? Then I will read the text once more and then let us talk today. Please listen to the text, page number 44. Ingi the monkey, Chinu the rabbit, Squeaky the squirrel, and Pecky the parrot were friends. They lived in a mango orchard. Pecky would taste a mango, and if it was sweet, Ingi would pluck it. Then all the four would share the fruit. One day, Ingi's cousin Cheeky came to spend his holidays. He was very naughty and selfish. He always wanted to eat the sweetest fruit. Pecky the parrot and Squeaky the squirrel thought of an idea. Pecky tasted the sweetest fruit, but Ingi the monkey did not pluck them as he wanted them for his cousin. Okay, today let us stop here and continue in the next class. And the most important thing you have to do is text reading. Text reading is very important, and you have to read the text as many times as possible and try to write the tough words, like the words that I have written here, the tough words, 10 times or 15 times in your book, and then it will be very thorough with the tough words and their meanings. Okay, wish you all the best. See you in the next class. Thank you.